Hi, I'm James Schilling-Law, and I'm here with Martina Bienfeld, who is the CEO of Zagreb Tourist Board. Now, I was lucky enough to be in Zagreb just a few weeks ago on my way to go to the Asta Destination Expo in Dubrovnik, and the whole purpose of my trip was to show that there is far more to Croatia than just Dubrovnik, which is wonderful, believe me, but I ended up going to Zagreb and Var and Split and finding out that there were a whole lot of other places I wanted to go. And as I was just telling Martina, I wish I'd spent more time in Zagreb because it is a lovely city. And we're going to talk about that city and find out all about it. And you'll see some of the shots that I took while I was there on Insider Travel Report. Now, first of all, Martina, how are you and where are you? I assume you are in Zagreb, right?
Yes, good morning, James. Actually, here is afternoon in Zagreb. I'm really happy to talk to you, and I would like really to say hello to everybody following us today. Yes, I'm really happy to have this opportunity to speak to you, and I'm really happy that you have visited the capital of Croatia, Zagreb, and also other cities and destinations that I really would like to recommend, and you have seen them. Beautiful, and Croatia is a small, beautiful, touristic country. So, yes, I'm really happy to tell you a little bit about Zagreb and about these gems that Croatia has and that are not still discovered.
Well, absolutely, and I only barely scratched the surface of Zagreb, but what would you say, in your view, are the most compelling reasons for, you know, specifically American travelers to visit Zagreb?
Yeah, I think that Zagreb is a new city to be discovered by our dear tourists from the United States of America, because we are not like usually people like to discover the stars of tourism in Europe, like Paris, London, Venice. But we can say that in the second trip to Europe, Zagreb is one of the cities that should be discovered and visited. Because not only we are the youngest capital of European Union, one of the cities in European Union, but we are the capital of the country that is really easily reachable to all other destinations. So Zagreb can be discovered either discovering the European cities in the area, like Vienna, in Austria, Ljubljana in Slovenia, Zagreb, of course, in Croatia. Venice is also just 2 hours driving time from Zagreb. So discovering European cities or maybe discovering Croatia. So to fly into Zagreb would be the best way to discover Croatia, mm-hmm. because as a capital, it is really special and cozy.
Yeah,
that's I would say.
Cozy is a good word.
I hope so you felt that when you visited us a few weeks ago. And what is also charming with Zagreb, it's a green and not big city. So maybe it's interesting to say that we are less than 1 million inhabitants in Zagreb. And when we do promote our city, we usually say that Zagreb is the city with million hearts. And we really are very happy to be a new destination interesting in tourism, and we really are the city that that combines Central European architecture and Mediterranean way of life.
No, it is a beautiful city, and it really is a city of parks and squares. In fact, my impression, and talking with the guide who took me a wonderful tour around, said it really felt like a more relaxed version of Budapest or Vienna. And which stands to reason, given its history, you know, in the Austro-Hungarian Empire, right?
Exactly. And maybe I hope that our dear travelers from the United States will also discover this mix of Vienna and mix of Budapest, because during the Austro-Hungarian Empire, the downtown was built, and so the most important buildings and the sites were built during that time. So we can smell in the air this Austrian influence, but also, as I have already mentioned, we usually like to be outside. We like to drink coffees. We like to meet new people. We like to have fun and to be relaxed, like other, for example, people who are living in Croatia, like on the coast, like Mediterraneans. So full of a spirit, full of positive energy and good vibration and feelings.
Well, certainly, I even had a little time to do that coffee thing. I sat outside the coffee and also sat outside at a restaurant, and just, you got to have that time. There's plenty of places in Zagreb to do that, and it really was kind of getting the feel for the place. Now, you mentioned earlier, and the city is indeed divided into what you call upper and lower town. Just tell us the distinction between those two parts.
Yes, gladly. The upper town is the place where we started to build Zagreb long time ago. So Zagreb is almost 1,000-year-old city. So the upper town is this beautiful place surrounded with small medieval houses, churches, beautiful cafes, galleries, museums. And it is one of the most beautiful parts of the city with this ancient flair, I dare to say. And this upper town is connected with the downtown, actually lower town, that I've already described as a part of the city that was built during the Austria and the Hungary Empire.
That's the one with the parks and all the things and the beautiful areas.
Yes, parks that are architecturally built as parks, and they are protected in that sense. But this upper town and the low town are connected with funicular. I don't know if you had the chance.
I did. I didn't go on it, but I saw it was there. And also, the upper town is where you find the capital of Croatia. And it's just that's where the parliament is? Okay.
It was like, yes, exactly. And it's a small, small, small square, right, with a beautiful small church of St. Mark's, right, with our beautiful roof and all actually located off Croatia, meaning politically or historically, is on that square. But about this funicular, this is the shortest funicular in Europe.
Oh.
The ride takes less than 60 seconds. And actually, it is usable because it does help us to be quickly in the upper town without losing too much energy or time to walk around.
Well, I guess my guy decided that I needed the exercise because he didn't.
So you didn't have bad experience.
We were walking down. It wasn't.
Yeah.
So we walked down, and he also wanted to show me the views, which are, you have a beautiful
view. Have you seen the tower with the cannon at noon? That every day we use this cannon, and we stopped using it after last year's earthquake. So now it's again in use because people were after last year's earthquake a little bit frightened, but now everything is in order. Everything is actually back to the old life, so we also have that beautiful experience marking every day that is 12 o'clock. And
yeah, well, that's interesting enough. I did not know, because of COVID and the pandemic, I don't think we even saw, the news didn't
maybe
come
you
out.
Were not there.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe you were not there at 12 o'clock, or I don't know at what time you have visited it.
Yeah, he warned me about the cannon, but we didn't hear that one. But
okay.
Now, let's talk a little bit about where visitors can stay in Zagreb. I was lucky, I think, to stay in one of the best properties, the Esplanade, which is an old, I guess it was a hotel built in the 20s or 30s, really to serve the Orient Express, because
exactly,
it is right there, and you can hear the trains, and it's kind of, romantic to feel like you're this is the old route, and this is a beautiful sort of Art Deco hotel. And I don't know, I'm sure, other places to stay as well in Zagreb, right?
Absolutely. We have some 70 hotels. The majority of the hotels are 4- and 5-star properties.
Right.
But I'm really happy that you stayed at the Esplanade. It is an iconic hotel for the country. And as you have mentioned, it was built actually for the passengers of Orient Express. And they took this night over here in Zagreb, and they proceeded to Istanbul. Of course, Orient Express started in Paris. And I heard that this year or next year, Orient Express will be again on the rails.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's correct. But it will go to Italy, not to Istanbul this time. So, and this property is really, I would always like to recommend it because in the year of 2019, it was rewarded as the best historical hotel in Europe.
Wow.
But beside of that, yes, and I'm happy that you've been there. We really have all sorts of hotels for all sorts of purposes, and all. I think everybody can find the hotel or a place to stay in Zagreb, no matter what are the reasons to visit Zagreb, definitely.
Well, just it is such a small city that you can easily get around walking,
exactly,
or taking the funicular, the quick one. Now, let's talk a little bit about food, dining. I had a lovely meal out there in one place, and of course, the Esplanade I had dinner in. But what are kind of the specialties there, and where can you find great food?
Everywhere. I really am happy to say that we can really find beautiful places, beautiful restaurants, beautiful sites, and the gastronomy in Zagreb is diverse. Actually, we had also in the past influences from different sides of Europe. For example, we are really famous for seafood, as actually our coast with more than 1,000 islands is a beautiful, rich sea with a seafood. Okay. And Zagreb is away from Opatija, for example, the oldest touristic destination in Croatia. Only 1 hour and 15 minutes driving time. So we really are happy to have fresh ingredients and from the sea and from the surroundings of Zagreb, as we have also all the things and ingredients on the markets that have been produced actually in Zagreb or around. So I would like to say that when we are speaking about gastronomy, we can suggest either Michelin star restaurants, either our typical Croatian food, which are pastries, then turkey with some special kind of pasta. Then I hope so that you've tried the štrukli. This is really
good. Yeah, I did. I tried this.
You like it?
I did like it. Although I had to realize, somebody told me to put lots of sugar on it, and it became a really good dessert. So
you can, yes, we can do it. Either we can boil them, or we can put them in the oven, or put salt or sugar. We can mix and play.
Tell our viewers what exactly this is, because
this is a pastry filled with cottage cheese.
That's right.
Yes, and it's really tasty and special and different, and could be eaten in different ways. So depends on somebody's prefer to have a salty meal or a sweet, or
right,
we can really play with it.
Well,
I wanted just to conclude that really we have different influences, the Hungarian from Austria, then from Italy. So we have a really mixture of everything and prepared in a nice, I think, way.
No, and food was excellent. I had the ritzy strictly at the Esplanade for my dessert. That's where the waiter said, if you want it to be dessert, put sugar on top of it.
And so I did. Exactly.
So I just kept putting, he actually gave me, how many packets do you want? And I think I used them all, but that's another story. But it was a great, great meal, and I had another great meal there. And I really wanted to explore some more because it does, like, there's a lot of stuff going on there. Now let's talk a little bit about, you actually have a sort of unique collection of museums in the town, and one very interesting one. But let's talk a little bit about what you offer.
When we speak about the offer of galleries and museums in Zagreb, we have some information like that. We have the biggest number of museums and galleries per capita if we measure that with the people who are living in a city. But what is maybe special in Zagreb, we have Museum of Broken Relationships.
We walked in that briefly. I said I could probably put in a whole wing just for myself, but that's another story. So I have
me
that.
Too,
it,
was, okay. yeah.
It was a very unique museum, and then you have the Naive Art, I think, too, is another
exactly.
one.
Exactly.
Really interesting things, right?
different special museums, and also maybe one example is that from Zagreb started the Museum of Illusions that are now, they have franchises all over the world, like 30 museums on every continent. I think a lot of them in the United States. But right. The first one was opened here in Zagreb, and we helped, as a Zagreb Tourist Board, we helped them we pushed them to start this great story about the museums.
Yeah, and also I understand maybe the Museum of Broken Relationships might end up being a franchise someday, somewhere. I think.
But it visited.
It is?
It was, it visited the United States several times. They were invited by the museums from the United States. So actually, this was also one of the connections between United States and Croatia and Zagreb.
No, that's great. It was very interesting. I didn't have enough time to go to a lot of the museums, so that means why I have to come back and see it.
For the next time, yeah.
Now, how can visitors best experience Zagreb? How long should they stay? And what are kind of the essential experiences, would you say, quickly, in terms of what they...
Yeah, of course, we are really recognizable as a city break destination. So I would recommend 2 or 3 nights to stay in Zagreb. That would be optimum. Not to discover only the city, but the small destinations and areas around Zagreb, which are also nice. And as I mentioned, the party is only 1 hour driving time from, if you would like to go to the Adriatic. Also, we can visit Zagreb anytime. I mean, we have a lot of different activities and also projects through whole year. We start with the most famous ski race after the new year, and we finish with the best European Christmas market, because Zagreb was actually awarded 3 times in a row as the city who has the best Christmas market in Europe. So really, I would like to invite everybody to be in Zagreb in December or anytime during the year. It's really nice, I think.
Yeah, no, and I love Christmas markets in Europe. I've been to many off the Danube on a river cruise. And I was told that you at Zagreb have one of the best in Europe. So I have to come back for that one. Now, where can travel advisors, who are our viewers, go to get more information about Zagreb so they can, you know, help their clients understand and where to book?
Yes, I would like to invite really everybody who is interested in visiting Zagreb and Croatia to contact us, Zagreb Tourist Board, because we are a non-profit organization and we really would like to be the specialists and the people who would recommend then the best of the needs that clients would like to experience in Zagreb and Croatia. So not only for Zagreb, but also for the other part of our beautiful country, we would gladly be here to contact with other professionals or special needs your advisors.
Is there anything else you want to tell our 85,000 travel advisors here about Zagreb and what they should tell their clients?
Yes, I would like also to invite them to check on our website, because interview is really short, and in this few minutes, it's not possible maybe to explain what the city of Zagreb is to somebody who have never been to Croatia or Zagreb. And also, I would really invite cordially everybody to contact us so we can provide them with anything they might need when thinking about Zagreb and maybe suggesting capital of Croatia, because we are the city on a human scale. And please, I would like to welcome everybody to Zagreb.
Well, that phrase, a city on the human scale, is quite appropriate for Zagreb. I look forward to returning to explore not just the Museum of Failed Relationships, which sounded intriguing, but to really spend some quality time in your squares, in your cafes, seeing the other museums, and really sort of soaking up. This is a city where you can really relax. It's, you know, you may have been to Vienna, you may have been to Budapest, but this city really is much more those are wonderful places, believe me, but this one I think you have to sit around and experience a bit. Martina, I want to thank you for taking the time to talk with us about Zagreb. I'm sorry I missed you when I was there, but glad to see you.
Me too. I'm so next time in Zagreb or
next time on Zagreb we'll get together. And I really do want to get back to Croatia because it was a marvelous trip. And I had been to Dubrovnik, as everybody has millions of times. Wonderful place.
Dubrovnik is unique, absolutely.
Yeah, mostly off of cruise ships, but to see the rest, a little bit of the rest of Croatia, and there are many, many, many more places, and it's such a welcoming country, and it was actually one of the first countries to open long before, and it's one of the reasons why I wanted to go there initially. But again, thank you so much, Martina, for spending some time with us.
Thank you very much, and really welcome to everybody who is interested in Zagreb, Croatia. Thank you so much. All the best.
I'm James Schillinglaw, and this is Insider Travel Report.